his mind he must have thought every outlaw in the land. And when he turned 18, he joined the rodeo. He went from town to town, breaking horses and bones. He must have won 1,000 trophies. Some say he was the best. He rode every brawl that ever came out of the way. His body bore the scars. It was a price he had to pay. So he started drinking whiskey. Said it helped to ease the pain. And then one night in Oakey City, he found the Bible by his bed. John 3:16 had been underlined in red. And in that little rundown hotel, he met someone who turned his life around. Now he's rescued more cowboys than all the rodeo planned. They called him Rodeo Preacher. Lord, he could buy them all. He would lend a helping hand when some cowboy take a fall. Well, he rode the rodeo circuit, Calvary down to Galveston. Yeah, he led cowboys to Jesus, and that's how the West was won. They called him Rodeo Preacher. He would lend a helping hand if some cowboy take a fall. But he rode the rodeo circuit, Calvary down to Galveston. Song right here, and I hope you do too, because it keeps, to me, it keeps it real. Amen.
Amen.
Oh, yeah. Church down the street, I was sitting in the congregation. I was listening to the preacher preach. Yeah, we had a good time. Love all over the place. We was talking about the blood of Jesus and singing Amazing Grace. Gave a little money, all I could afford. And then me and my brothers and sisters down there praising the Lord. Yeah, we had a good time thinking about the promised land. And when I got home on Sunday morning, I was feeling like a brand new man. Monday morning, my car wouldn't start. I didn't get to work until 10. The boss said, if you wanna work here, don't you ever let it happen again. There was people grumbling and carrying on. I had to listen to all that fuss. I tell you, brother, it's just about enough to make a man wanna cuss. I went over to the corner, yeah. And there wasn't nobody but me. I said, thank you, Jesus, because I'm not the man I used to be. I'm gonna make it. I'll make it through the week, cause I know. Come Sunday morning, I'll be sitting on the very front row. Saturday evening, an old friend came by. He said, come on, let's go downtown. We'll find us a bar and we'll pick up some girls and we'll go fooling around. I said, hold on, buddy. I'm sure glad you came, cause I got something I want you to see. Why don't you sit down here and let me tell you about what the Lord has done for me. I said, Jesus loves you, and he died for your sins. And if you let me, I'll be glad to lead you straight to him. We talked for a little while, then we got down on our knees. Now Sunday morning, every Sunday morning, you're sitting right here with me. In the very front row. Hey, man, I tell you what, I ain't a preacher, and I ain't a judge, just a witness. Man, what a great calling. Everybody loves Jesus. He turns us into a witness.
That's right.
I can't quote a whole lot of scripture, but I can tell you what Jesus has done for me.
Amen, brother.
Buddy, you're looking at a man that the fires of hell was about to get so many times.
Go ahead.
But Jesus, he loves a knucklehead.
Amen.
He loves everybody.
Yeah, amen.
And I'm going to tell you what, this is where it all started, though. I think somebody said something about pride.
Amen, brother.
Boy, I tell you, I watch them John Wayne movies, and I was a prideful man. You know, wanting to be tough. Till I got by myself, away from everybody, and then I cried like a little baby. Wondering why it's a doggone hurt.
Yeah.
Anybody else ever been like that?
Yeah.
Oh, boy, and then I'd get around somebody, wipe my face off, and I'd act tough.
How foolish. That's
right.
How foolish. But life started when I just humbled myself and asked God to help me.
Amen.
Just asking to help me. And he did. And he does every day. Lord, help me walk another mile. One more mile. I'm tired of walking all alone, all alone. Lord, help me smile, another smile, one more smile. I'm tired of walking on my own.
Yes.
I need to feel the touch. your nails start. Into your master plan. Makes it easy.
That's right.
It's hard to fight against him.
Go ahead.
It don't matter where you've been, it matters where you're at and where you're going. Amen.
Amen.
It don't matter where you've been. It don't matter what you've lost. It don't matter how you've seen. It don't matter what it's caused. It don't matter anymore. That old life you lived in sin, you're still loved by the Lord.
Amen.
It don't matter where you've been. I've been down the road that's full of sin for the soul. And I've hung my head in shame when sin left me holding the blame. When I found grace at Calvary, blinded eyes began to see. You don't have to live in sin. It don't matter where you've been. Have you given up on hope? Have you failed and lost your way? Now with life, you just can't cope. God has a plan for you today. You can leave it all behind. Then your new life you will find. Just look to Him and you will see. It don't matter where you been. You see, I've been down the road that's full of pain for the soul. And I've hung my head in shame when sin left me holding the blame. When I found grace at Calvary, my blinded eyes began to see. still get me. It don't matter where you've been. Boy, if that ain't good news, I don't know what is. Amen. Because every one of us is bloated, haven't we? I can handle the ones I blowed before I got saved. You know, I thank God for the blood, but it's hard sometimes, you know, when I know better. And I still get ambushed. And I can't give Satan all the credit. Sometimes it's just a man I see in the mirror.
That's right, brother.
We need him every day. Amen.
Amen.
And I'm glad that God adopted me.
Amen.
I know a little bit about adoption. I got two, my oldest kids are adopted. And I'm going to tell you something. When God, when we think out, call out, whisper out, cry out to God, and say, help me, he means business. When he hears that, it's amazing how much work he does. He does the work.
That's right.
We can't do it. That's what gets me. We can't do it.
That's right.
I'm shut up and sing. But I'm blessed. I'm telling you what, I'm blessed. And I know you are too. And I know you know it. But don't it feel good to rub elbows with other people that know they're blessed? I tell you what, sometimes you ever see somebody and you say, oh Lord, here they come.
Yeah.
Ain't nothing good. It's all not bad. But I'm going to tell you something. It's fun when you rub elbows with people that knows they're blessed too. Amen.
Hey,
dear.
Was it Macedonia Baptist Church?
It sure is good to be saved.
Hey, Dr. Music every Wednesday night.
Y'all
come be with us.
He goes above and beyond with everything.
Amen.
I've never made a fortune. It's probably too late now. Oh, but I don't worry about that much. 'Cause I'm happy anyhow. As I go along life's journey, I'm reaping better than I sowed. I'm drinking from my saucer, 'cause my cup has overflowed. I ain't got a lot of riches. Sometimes the going's rough, but I've got a friend in Jesus. And that makes me rich enough. I thank God for all his blessings on me and the mercies he's bestowed. I'm drinking from my saucer, 'cause my cup has overflowed. Well, sure, I've been through some storms. And I know that there were times when, well, my faith must have got a little thin. But I just kept trusting Jesus. And you know what it seems like? One day those dark clouds broke and that sun started shining. So Lord, help me not to grumble or complain about the tough road I have hold. I'm drinking from my saucer, 'cause my cup has overflowed. If I should go on living, if the way gets deep and rough. I won't ask for any more blessings, 'cause I'm already blessed enough. May I never be too busy to help another bear his load. I'm drinking from my saucer, 'cause my cup has overflowed. Yes, I'm drinking from my saucer, 'cause my cup has overflowed. My cup has overflowed. Yeah. Bless you, give the Lord a hand, amen. I tell you what, if there's one thing I want to do more than anything else, and that's to make God smile.
Amen.
And I believe that God smiles when his young'uns get along and love one another.
That's right.
And he's the center of it, amen.
Right.
About to run out of time, and I won't sing so much, but this, I won't sing this in here because
going,
of
it. Don't worry about the time.
I tell you what, I was reading something today, and God still got a lot to work on me. I'm not trying to be false humility, but he still got a lot to do. But you know what? He's done a lot, too. I've come a long way, y'all.
Yeah.
I mean, y'all didn't
Amen,
know me.
Amen.
And you know what? I wasn't a bad person. I really wasn't. But when I wasn't saved, I had a one-way ticket to hell.
That's right.
And I was headed there, and it seemed like everything I do, it would blow up in my face. I had good intentions, but, you know, now when I look back, I can see, well, Satan just had me, what strings just worked me like a fiddle, I reckon, you know. But the old man's dead, amen.
That's right.
All that's in the past.
Yeah.
I got some people like to bring it up. That's all right. Now and then, an old friend of mine that I've not seen in some time will stop by and ask me, "Hey Dave, where have you been? What's on your mind?" They wonder why I'm not drinking and still painting this old town green. I tell them I'm serving Jesus now, and the old man is dead. And the man you see before you may look a lot the same. I may wear the same clothes and have the same old name, but you're looking on the outside. If you could see inside instead, you would see a brand new man. 'Cause the old man is dead. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. I used to live such a wicked life, I had no hope inside. I was lost in the darkness, searching for the light. And then one night in a little church, after hearing what the preacher said, I gave my life to Jesus. And now the old man is dead. And the man you see before you may look a lot the same. I may wear the same clothes time with one another and with God. Amen.
Amen.
But I believe I'm the one's going to be leaving him more blessed than anybody. God bless y'all. God bless. Come on.
We got one more song. David Lawson. Let's give David Earl Lawson. Dave. Let's give him another.
Yeah. Yeah.
He brought the spirit with him tonight. Yes, he did. Amen. We got one more song. How Great Thou Art by the Rocky River Band. And then Pastor's going to close it out tonight.
What pastor? That one?
Right here.
I'll make sure I got him on here.
Thank you, Jesus.
Jimmy, you got your stage set?
Yeah, I believe I got it right.
You got it. That's all. Mm-hmm.
Thank you. We got three cameras.
Glory to God.
They ain't no song for
man. Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen. That was real good, brother. Amen. First time I heard you, man, but that's good. You got CDs?
Yes, sir. Anybody wants them, please. And they ain't for sale. Get what you want. I'm serious. They right up here in this box.
I'll give you something to anyway, brother.
He takes donations, but he's not.
Y'all sing along with us.
I know this is the same that sang with us. Thank you.
dismiss. I need for you to pray for my daughter. She was tested positive today with the coronavirus.
All right.
She's lost her smell. She's lost her taste.
Yeah.
She's real sick. But you know, we got power over this.
Amen.
And he said, where two or three agrees together is touching anything, it shall be done.
Amen.
And I believe, David, I want you to come and I want you to hold the preacher's hand. And I want y'all to pray that God will rebuke this sickness from her. Nobody deserves this. Nobody deserves this. The devils are working. But you know the Bible said where sin abounds, grace much more abounds. But I want you to pray, join hands together with one of your loved ones. And her name is Nisi. And also my mother, she's 90 years old. And she's having problems with urocracy. With her legs, she's failed, broke both of her hips. But her name is Louise.
Amen. Praise
and
God.
If any of y'all have got loved ones that are sick in body, I believe Jimmy's wife, Melinda, she needs a touch from God. And there's a lot of people today, I've got brothers that I love dearly. I've got one that's so mad at me now that he could just kill me. But I don't know what to do but just leave him in God's hands. That God would save him and bring him to an altar. But I want us to stand together and let's reference the Holy Ghost. He's here in this service. David sung his heart out. The Rocky River Band has played their heart out. The preacher has preached his heart out. So let's stand together and hold hands. And let's just rebuke this sickness right now. Go ahead, preacher.
Thank you, Lord.
We praise you.
One name I want to mention, I hope you heard them tonight, and names I mentioned also in the prayer. Those that need prayer, a lot of people need prayer, and I hope you'll be praying for them in the days ahead, okay? And God bless you, and you're dismissed.
Amen.
I'm good to see y'all.
Thank you.
I don't know. That's a cabbage patch, ain't it? That little cabbage patch.
That little girl, what's her name?
Kaylin.
She wants that.
You want to go bye-bye?
She wants that.
You
do? I guarantee Kaylin.
You want to go bye-bye?
That doll. What's your name?
Yeah.
Huh?
Yes, she would. All right, goodbye, everybody. Every Wednesday night over here at the Macedonia Baptist Church. They start serving food at 6 and singing at 7. If you want to see the video, all the videos we've been doing, just go to YouTube, Enter Macedonia, M-A-C-E-D-O-N-I-A, Macedonia Baptist Church, and you'll see about maybe 7 or 8 shows we've done already. Okie doke. All right, goodbye.